Hi guys, welcome back. I want to talk about the SHTF handgun, or at least my thoughts on having an SHTF handgun. It's one of the most important things because, one of the most important tools because it's something that you can carry with you at all times. And for me, a good SHTF handgun is something that you should be able to carry all the time. And for me, I wanted the pistol that I was going to rely on under extraordinary circumstances to be the same gun that I carry under normal circumstances, because you never know when the normal circumstances are going to become extraordinary circumstances. Now, SHTF, when the shit hits the fan, it's basically when you have civil unrest, you have rioting, you have a situation where law enforcement can't necessarily get to you, and you can't necessarily rely on 911. And that's a lot of times that happens under normal situations. If somebody breaks into your house, you have to respond, you have to act. It doesn't mean you have to really confront the person, but you do have to make some decisions. And you may not always be able to rely on the police getting there on time to really help you out. So in these under certain extraordinary circumstances, you want a gun that's reliable, you want a gun that's dependable, you want a gun that you're comfortable with, and a gun that you're knowledgeable about, okay? You gotta be able to use the gun. So those are some key things I would look for. And those are the key things I was looking for when I was choosing the SHTF gun. The way I looked at it, I wanted my SHTF gun to be the type of gun that I could use under normal circumstances. Everyday carry, concealed carry, because you never know. I wanted it something that you never know when a normal circumstance is going to become an extraordinary circumstance. If you're away from home and there's a big event, whatever gun you're carrying, it has to be something that you can trust during an extraordinary event, SHTF or anything like that. So, and SHTF can include a power down, grid down scenario, a solar flare, something like that. Something extraordinary that would compromise the entire system. So I would look for something that you can actually use effectively. I would go to a shooting range, rent out some guns, see what you're good at, and even before you do that, do some research. Do your own research. I'm not pretending to be an expert in any of this type of stuff. Do your own research. Look for something that fits your criteria. Are you looking for something with a great deal of capacity? And get yourself a 9mm. 9mm have a greater capacity than 40s and 45s. 40s and 45s are bigger rounds, bigger bullets hitting the target, greater stopping power. Can you afford an ammunition? What are you looking for in ammunition? Full metal jacket 9mm, it's not going to have a stopping power of a full metal jacket 45. Now you can get yourself some hollow point 9mm, and they have more stopping power than your typical 9mm full metal jacket. However, it's not going to be as significant as the 45 hollow points. You know, and the reason why I moved towards 45 is because I was focused on stopping power. Okay, I wanted something with good capacity, and the Glock 21 had 13 rounds, which was a good capacity. But I also wanted something that was easy, ammunition that was easy to find. I also wanted something that would have significant stopping power. Some people lean towards, I want to have more rounds to put more shots on the target. Maybe they're concerned about multiple assailants. Well, with 13 rounds, I thought that was sufficient to deal with multiple assailants. It is really a matter of what you prefer. I prefer the 45, I prefer the Glock, and I prefer the Glock because it didn't have the external safeties. It does have three internal safeties, so if you drop it, it won't just go off. But I was concerned that I would mess up with a trigger if there was something went down, even if it was just a normal circumstances, somebody was attacking me. I wanted to keep something. I wanted the gun to be really, really simple. And for me, that's something that really worked, and that's something I would recommend for others. Now, Glock isn't the only type of gun, obviously. It's not the most ergonomic gun, although I feel it's pretty ergonomic enough for me. There's guns that are more ergonomic. There's guns that can shoot further and do a lot of cool things. But a lot of these exotic guns, it's harder to get extra parts for. That was a big factor for me. A Glock, it's so simple. A lot of us can pretty much replace the parts on our own. And it's also a weapon that has been used by a number of organizations, such as, I'm not just talking about military and law enforcement, but various other organizations. It's been put through a certain amount of testing. It's been tried a lot, and it's something that, has actually held up against the test of time. And there's other guns that have been able to do that as well. There's certain Berettas, and there's other guns that have been able to do that as well. It's just that this was something that met my criteria, what I was looking for. Another thing I would encourage people to look into is, how reliable, okay? if you need, going back to the extra parts reference, where are you going to find extra parts if this, if you buy a $1,000 gun and you can barely find ammunition? You know, things like that. You got to think about that. Doesn't mean that I don't want to FN 5.7. I definitely do. That would be pretty cool. But that's when I make a lot more money. Right now, I'm sticking to the basics. 45. One thing I like about the 45 is that I was always able to find 45. It costs more than 9mm, which is a downside. But you know, I was always able to find it, even during the ammo and gun shortage crisis of 2013. I was still able to find that, and that was pretty reassuring for me. So those are some things I would keep in mind. Just want to share my thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.